You. I thought I couldn't face you. But I couldn't face myself. I know you'll always be there. Maybe that's okay. You're part of this adventure. Part of me. Thank you. Now. I will return the fireflies. I'm coming for you, dragon. With her confidence renewed, a newfound power coursed through her. I feel like I can do anything.
Yeah, word, man.
Light as a feather. Like cutting through Eldorado's crab apple pie. The world welcomed her. She felt that she could touch the sky. She felt that she could touch the sky. A tall tower loomed overhead. Many moons shone above. First it was built. Another obstacle? Ha! After what I've been through, you really think that will stop me? Robin's voice echoed over the age-old crumbling stones. A lone figure stood, unbowed, defiant. It drew her to it. Her foe rose before her. No breath in its body, but no less terrifying. I'm up to the task. Nothing's moving. Must be more to do. That's it! A gust of fresh air rewarded Robin's efforts. As she rose up the stairs, Robin knew the tower's purpose. To watch over a long forgotten land, should ancient evil stir. No statue this time, but bone and scale. Its fire-wreathed home, waiting.
There you are! And here I come! Maybe this wasn't such a good idea. It was a great idea!
The world darkened around Robin. She had reached the Dragon's Mountain. For the first time, Robin felt no fear. She knew she had all she needed.
Feels warm on my soles.
Before her, a molten sea stretched into the distance. It did not slow her down.
I laugh in the face of lava. In its stead, a cold dread crept up her spine.
Like my village, but it can't be. It's a trick. It has to be.
An eerily familiar sight awaited her.
That's my house. How? Eldereva! No! Wait! Come back! Oh, no! No, no!
Only emptiness remained. Only emptiness remained. Her thoughts raced ahead of her.
This can't be real. A trick. I can't let it be real.
She gripped the chain with furious determination.
I know you're there! Roar all you like! It won't stop me!
You can forgive me. Torn between rage and regret. Robin pushed ever upwards. even through adversity within and without, her determination shone bright. She had grown. I hope you find your peace. Almost there. Chilling winds shook her to the bone. Still she climbed. Glad we're on the same page. Every stride, pushing against, storm and snow. Defiant. Unwavering. One step after the other. That's Bow. That's where I last saw... Lump!
Human! How are you here?
Not sure.
I'm so glad to see you. After I left you, I felt so confused. I didn't know if I'd done the right thing.
Lump, see how far you come. You've grown big. Lump did right thing.
Don't go!
To Robin, but we'll always be there in the membering.
I'll make sure to keep you there. Goodbye, little lump. Hello, dragon. Here I come. Finally. Robin readied herself for a confrontation.
Right. This is it.
Hello? Bit of an anticlimax.
When she first set out, Robin wanted to return the sacred fireflies to their rightful home. But now she realized that, regardless of how her adventure ended, the journey had forever changed her. Standing there, she felt reflective. Every choice, every hardship, and every challenge had been leading to this. No moment was wasted. It was a life lived, and it was hers.
Come forth, dragon. Every twist and turn of my journey has led me to you. Why did you scare away all our sacred fireflies?
Why? They were in my way.
They're with me now, and I won't let you harm them.
You cannot win this battle. Begone!
You can't just make me disappear.
I am the Unmaker, the Ender of Worlds.
Not this one.
All things must come to an end. Your friends, your family, you.
Not if I can help it.
In time, even dragons fade. Ponder this elsewhere.
One person can make a difference. I know that now.
You have been reading the wrong stories, little one. Sometimes things just end.
You're going to have to go through me.
Yes. That's what I've been trying to do.
Ha-ha! The great dragon stumped by a little girl.
You can't hurt me, and I can't hurt you.
And what is your solution, little one?
Sure. Maybe just talk it out?
Very well. You may ask me one question.
Make this one count, Robin.
It is fading into the void. It is burning into nothingness.
Why? Why is this happening?
It is time. No more, no less.
Can it be stopped?
No. It is inevitable. The wheel turns, the cycle continues. You have had your one question. I have work to do.
Please! I've overcome so much to get here. I've had to face what I am. And what I'm not. It was a struggle. And I think it always will be.
I envy your fight.
It can be yours too. You can change things. You can't hurt me!
I did not aim for you. Some things are not to be changed, not to be stopped. They must be accepted.
I can't accept this.
Learn to dream again.
What happened?
It's all gone, I'm afraid.
It can't be just gone. Why couldn't I do anything? Why couldn't I save it?
There was nothing to be done. Everything has a time to go, even worlds.
But I don't want that. I feel like a failure.
That's silly. You didn't fail because you couldn't win.
I couldn't.
The dragon is part of the world cycle. It cannot be broken.
What's the point of all of this? I failed before I even started.
You recovered the fireflies. Ancient energies born of the same cycle. Between you, them, and your book, you'll work it out.
Wait! What do you mean?
There was only one place left to look. Astoria was gone, but the fireflies still remained, waiting for a new beginning. You're rebuilding the world, aren't you? And you're starting with my memories. A fruitful work. A remembrance of home. I've run out of fireflies. We're stuck. There's still something missing. Hey, you're still here, Firefly. Can you help? That's it, Firefly. Now you're ready for a new story. And I have to say goodbye too. Thank you, Firefly. Again. But you're not really here, are you? You didn't make it. You knew, didn't you? That you wouldn't? That's why the Firefly came to me. They knew too. So these are my memories of you. That's where you live now, isn't it? Within me. I'll hold you close. I'll take you with me. Always. Let's see what adventures lie ahead.
Hello, journal. Reading these dusty pages makes me feel old. I reread them so many times as a kid, taking myself back to those dark moments, reassuring myself it would all be okay. That helped. You helped. I still miss Gran every day. Sometimes I hear her laugh in the back of my mind. Abby reminds me of her. Insatiably curious and fiercely independent. I hope she never loses that. Mum's coming to live with us for a bit. I hope her and Abby are going to make some memories of their own. They're already both obsessed with cat videos and Instasnap. Abby's birthday is coming up. Maybe I'll get her a journal of her own. She says she wants to be a writer.
Thank you.